Whoa, look what we've got today. We've got some OMG Big Sister and Little Sister nesting dolls. Let's take a closer look at these. On this big one right here is Swag and MC Swag. Let's take a look at all around the nesting doll. We've got dollar signs to stay true to the MC Swag and Swag theme. And it says OMG Swag on the nesting doll. All right, you guys know nesting dolls have lots of other little tiny parts. Let's see who's next. We've got Neonlicious. So here is Neonlicious and Neon Cutie on the second nesting doll. Big Sister and Little Sister look so cute together. Let's check the next one. Who's hiding in there? It's Royal Bee and Queen Bee. Here's Royal Bee's super curly, pretty gold and brown hair. And they've got glitter all over their nesting doll. Let's check the next one. Looks like it's Lady Diva and Diva. And these nesting dolls just keep getting tinier and tinier. And the next one is, can you guys guess what it is? Let's just take it right on out. It is Neonlicious's little purse. In case you guys don't know, this little purse is the What's in My Purse Miss Positive. And the very last nesting doll is the tiniest of them all. It is a red dollar sign nesting doll. So red dollar sign means MC Swag, of course. Okay, now here are all of our nesting doll pieces. Now, how does this go back together? We start off with the smallest piece, which is the last nesting doll, and we find the second smallest piece, which is the Miss Positive purse. So the dollar sign nesting doll goes inside the Miss Positive nesting doll, and now the Miss Positive nesting doll goes inside the Lady Diva and Diva nesting doll. Perfect. Now this nesting doll goes inside the Royal Bee and Queen Bee nesting doll. And the Royal Bee and Queen Bee nesting doll goes inside the Neonlicious and Neon Cutie nesting doll. And finally, the Neonlicious and Neon Cutie nesting doll goes inside our biggest nesting doll, and that's MC Swag and Swag. Now, these aren't just any old nesting dolls. These are magical nesting dolls. So let's give them a shake-a-shake and get them some magical surprises. All right, so here they all are. Let's check the very first biggest nesting doll and see what surprises MC Swag and Swags brought us. Here we go, let's pop the nesting doll open and give it a magical shake. A shake, shake. Whoa, what just fell from that nesting doll? It almost knocked everything out. We've got a Sparkly Critters and a Unicorn Crush. Yay, all poopsie stuff. So this is the brand new Sparkly Critters Wave 2. In case you guys missed it, these are the brand new Unicorn Crushes. It's sand and glitter that makes up slime. So let's go with our Sparkly Critter first and see which little cutie we get. All right, so here's our Unicorn Magic and Unicorn Shimmer. Let's twirl our cans, a vending machine, and this should be our Silly Soda can. What do we have? We've got Farta, Passion Poop. And this should be our special bag to keep our slime in after we finish making it. And ooh, looks like we've got a new one. Okay, it's Poopitos, Lime Poops, oh. And here's our Unicorn Spoon. And this shall be our critter. Let's see which one we've got this time. We've got a new one, it's Ducky. Oh, so cute. Look at the eyelashes and the pretty colors. And there is its bill. So is it a pooper or does it spit? If we look on the back, there's a heart, so that means it's a pooper. All right, everything we need is already inside our little ducky. All of our slime powder. All we need is to fill our soda bottle all the way up and feed our little critter. So our little ducky is Quacks from the Early Bird Turds, and she's a rare. Let's give her some water. Put her pacifier back in and start shaking her for 1 minute, just like all the poopsies. All right, now it's time for her to get the slime out. And there she goes, ugh, grody. She's definitely a pooper. Ducky! Okay, so that's all the slime we've got. Now we're gonna let this sit for 10 minutes and add our unicorn magic and shimmer in there. But while we're waiting, we can see which unicorn crush we've got. We're going to need two bowls for this, and you guys are gonna see why in just a bit. So here is the slime. We don't even have to make it. It's all nice and ready for us. We've got a set of instructions, and this is what we get to open first. So, oh, we've got green slime. Nice. And these are already scented. We don't even need to add scent in them. I'm thinking this might be green apple just from the color, but it could surprise us. I'm gonna give it a whiff in just a bit. And we get a big chunk of it too. It's not a little bit, and it's so nice and clear. I love this. It's like that thick, clear slime with a tint of color. Very, very pretty. You don't even have to worry about air bubbles with this slime. Ooh, and it smells like vanilla. So, so good. You can never go wrong with smelling like a vanilla cupcake. And now over here, we're gonna get our unicorn horn out of its casing. We've got a yellow one. Ooh, this will go nice with the green slime. Let's unwrap and give it a quick soak. Just real quick, because you don't want it breaking in the water. Move it over our slime, and we're gonna crush. Whoa, look at that. We've got a whole bunch of holographic glitter pouring out of our horn. That is so pretty. Okay, now all you gotta do is mix it in with your slime. And then we'll see what this color combo gives us. Look at all those glitters. And with the sand, it gives you a nice big, big chunk of slime and a really, really cool crunchy texture. So we kind of ended up with like a neon yellow or a lime green slime. And when you're done playing with your slime, you can store it in your unicorn horn. But I think the slime might be too much for the unicorn horn. So you might want to put just a little bit in there. Okay, let's check up on our next slime. What happened to it? Oh, it's so little. I have a feeling that some of it is stuck inside Quacks. Okay, so no smell, but Quacks has a smell. Let's give her a smell. Ooh, she smells fruity. Now let's add some unicorn shimmer and see what color. Ooh, it goes so pretty with it. It's such a pretty color. So we don't have enough slime to take care of all of that glitter. So it's not really sticking all that well. But that is really neat. Let's see what unicorn magic does to it. I'm gonna add just a little bit because I know this makes it pearly. Oh, it's a tough slime, but it's a bummer because it's so pretty. And of course, now we can store it in our Pupitos bag so we can play with it later. All right, so Swag and MC Swag did an awesome job. They brought us some really cool surprises. Now it's Neonlicious's turn. Okay, here we go. We're gonna give it a magical shake, shake, shake. Ooh, whoa, what did we get? We've got a Disney Princess Comics minis, and it's a series one. Look how cool this packaging is. There's Ariel, Take a Stand, Jasmine, If the Shoe Fits, we've got Cinderella, and there's the Beast. He looks so much nicer in comic form. Alrighty, let's see what these are all about. Do we open it this way or do we pull it out? Oh, we pull it out. Cool, look at the collector's guide. And I think we got like a little poster with it. It's a comic, let's read it. It's Bayonet Stand with Princess Tiana and Prince Naveen. Here it is. Naveen, this bayonet stand is a great idea for promoting the restaurant. My ideas are occasionally still brilliant, yes? It's gonna be a lot of work, but if it's both of us, then we should get through it just fine. And where do you think you're going? Oh, he tried to escape her. Forgive me, Tiana, but I forgot I promised to accompany Lewis's vet today. But what about the bayonets? Voila, my replacement. Lottie? It's like playing kitchen when we were babies. You've never made a bayonet in your life. Oh, pish, how hard could it be? How about you handle the sales? Oh, money, that I know. That's cute. Okay, and here's the collector's guide. Here are all the ones we can get. We've got 12 to collect. So who do we get? Some mystery. Oh, that was a clue. I should have known. It's Princess Tiana. And she's got like a Cinderella dress on. How pretty is that? That was cute. Okay, so Neonlicious and Neon Cutie brought us a cute surprise. Next up, it's Royal Bee and Queen Bee. Let's see what they've got us. We're gonna give them a shake, shake, and a shake. Ooh, we've got chicken and lice goop. Ew, no way. Can we return this back to the nesting doll? It's a mix of slimy and chunks. Gross, gross. Okay, so let's see what's inside here. Oh, and it's got smelly scents. These are very fun to open, but also very gross. All right, let's open this can of chicken and lice scoop. Oh no. That is so gross. How do they make these look so disgusting? Ugh, would you guys open this bag? Okay, I'll do it for you guys. And something else fell out. Let's see what was in here. Are those maggots? They're squishy too. I hope this doesn't smell gross. Oh, the poopsie slimes I like, but this slime, no, and it's so sticky. Ew. Okay, that's what it looks like. Oh my gosh. I am not looking forward to smelling this. Ooh, I'm actually getting a whiff of it. So they were nice. They didn't give it a smell like how it looks. It smells so good. That's a real surprise there. Not the slime or anything else. It smells like coconut body lotion. Seriously, like Bahama Breeze or like a tropical type of spray. All right, let's add our besties in there. Nice maggots. Oh, gross. Now let's mix those in to make the ultimate slime. Look at that. Who knew something so hideous can smell so good? Well then, Queen Bee and Royal Bee pranked us, but their surprise was fun. So let's try Lady Diva and Diva. What do they have for us? Let's give them a shake, shake, and a shake. Holy guacamole, we've got another jump scare toy. It's a Pizzeria Simulator Freddy Fazbear. Let's look at all the ones we can get. Last time we got our little elephant. Look at Chica, she's got some maracas. Okay, let's see who we've got in this one. I want to go for Maraca Chica. Let's see who is in here. Be a good one, be a good one. We've got a duplicate of our little elephant. And he is a magician. Nice, nice. Okay, let's see about Miss Positive, our little purse. What has she got for us? She's tiny, but she comes with a mighty surprise. Here we go, we're gonna give her a shake and a shake. Ooh, did she bring what I think she brought? We've got an LOL Surprise Lil's Wave 2. Okay, let's see which little cutie we've got here. Will it be a pet, a little sister, or a little brother? Let's see, who have we got? Let's go for our first clue. Hopefully it's not a duplicate. Oh no, we've got a duplicate. We've got little shoes for a sis cheer. And here's the bag. Oh, it's cute, but it's a duplicate. So I think this is a pet. I don't think it's a little bro cheer, but I could be wrong. Wait, what? Oh, I was totally wrong. It's little Sailor Cutie, but she's still a duplicate. Hey, at least Miss Positive is keeping it positive and she tried. Any surprise is a good surprise. And here is our super tiny last nesting doll. It's so tiny. Oh, it's so tiny, it doesn't even open. But no worries, of course we can make something happen. Ooh, works every single time. Baldi's Basics and Educational Learning. Here are all the ones we can get. Last time we've got our broom, but he's not on here. Maybe we get another like secret character that's not listed on here. Who do we have? It's Baldi! Oh, he's got his ruler and everything, but it's Happy Baldi, so he's nice. Welcome to Baldi's Basic Learning and Education. I love my little pony. Oh, you do? Yes, I do. Well, it's the end of our show. I hope you guys enjoyed our LOLOMG nesting dolls and all the surprises they brought for us. They brought us a bunch of good surprises and a bunch of gross surprises. But any surprise is a good surprise as long as you have fun. Let me know in the comments section which nesting doll and its surprises were your favorite. And until next time, I will see you later. Bye for now.